generous man and a mentor to many. That's how former Qantas pilot Gary Criddle is being remembered after he and two others were killed when planes collided in Sydney's southwest.
We've learned more details about the tragedy as investigators gather evidence, including the disturbing fact that one of the planes had crashed before.
Gary Criddle loved to fly, a Qantas pilot for more than 36 years and part of the Royal Australian Air Force roulettes for 20. But tonight his family is mourning a much-loved aviator, mentor, husband and dad after the 72-year-old was confirmed as one of three men killed yesterday in a mid-air collision between two light planes at Belimbla Park, southwest of Sydney. Today, the Australian Transport Safety Bureau started its investigation. Now the seventh mid-air collision in the last 5 years.
Scouring through the site, looking for any recorded information we can, GPS units, mobile phones, anything that was on the planes.
One plane, a yellow Cessna 182, registered to New South Wales Air Flight Training in Albion Park. Gary was on board along with a 29-year-old trainee pilot. The other plane, a Jabiru, with a sole 60-year-old man on board. Investigators say a flight plan was lodged for the Cessna to fly from Cessnock headed for Wollongong. But as it tracked south, the Jabiru took off to perform circuit work nearby when the two collided mid-air.
This airfield is in uncontrolled airspace, meaning it's a pilot's responsibility to communicate their intention and position to other aircraft in the area. Whether or not that happened is now a key line of inquiry for investigators.
There are some very strict protocols and well-established protocols for planes to establish separation, but essentially they're doing that separation themselves.
Investigators also collating witness reports, CCTV and the aircraft's history, including reports the Jabiru had previously been involved in a crash landing in Queensland 2 years ago. Then owner Vic Pisani walked away but sold the aircraft shortly after.
Luckily avoided the fence on the way in.
Tonight, two planes are at the centre of an investigation as three families mourn lost loved ones. Taylor Aiken, 7 News.